All right, so welcome to this helper video that I'm going to create
to help you through step 5 of assignment 4.
It's a little bit nasty, so I thought I would give you a helping hand here. So the purpose of this step is I'm going to give you a number, and I'm going to give you a center point, and I'm going to ask you, are you between this point and this point? So if you're in this range right there, I want you to print out the word yay. All right, simple enough, you'd think. Not in that range, then I want you to come over here and say, hey, are you between this point and this point? And if you are, then I want you to print out, well, okay then. If you're outside of even that range, then what do you do? So if you're to the left of here or to the right of here, I want you to print out boo, because it failed both of those tests. Are you outside of that and outside of that? Sum up, let me drag a quote out of one of me and my wife's favorite movies, A Princess Bride.
Who are you? Are we enemies? Why am I on this wall? Where's Buttercup? Let me explain. No, there is too much. Let me sum up.
If we're between these two lines, I want yay. If we're between these two lines, I want okay.
Right, so let me show you.
Outside of that, I want boom.
So let's get to the Excel part of this.
It doesn't leave much time for dilly-dally.
You just wiggle your finger. That's wonderful.
I've always been a quick eater.
If we're between here and here, I want yay. So let's just say that the center point is 100, and this threshold is that minus 5%, and this one is 100 plus 5%. So if it's in between here and here, I want it to say yay. The problem is that there's no between function. I can't say between 95 and 105. So we've got to do a little math. So this formula is really pretty complex. We have to see if it's in between here and here. If it's between here and here, it's yay. If it's between here and here, it's okay. If it's outside of that, boo. This is a pretty long and involved formula. So I liken it back to that old and probably bad joke. How do you eat an elephant? One bite at a time. So this is going to take several bites. And I do it this way because it's A, it's easier to teach you, and B, it's easier to do. Whenever I have a very involved, long, nested formula, I'll break it up into little bits and pieces to make it easier. So let's say we have a value of 100 here. I want to say that are you greater than this value and less than that value? So first off, we have to come up with those values. So right in this cell here, I'm going to write a formula that says equals this minus parentheses, this times this cell here. Close my parentheses, and it better come up with 95. Awesome. So similar to here, I'm going to say equals this plus parentheses, this times this. We don't need the parentheses here, but maybe I'll skip them on this next one just to show you. So later on, we're going to need these thresholds as well, this plus or minus, this 100 plus or minus 10%. I'll go ahead and do those now because I know that I'm going to need these bites of the elephant later. So equals this minus this times this, 90. Equals this plus this times this. So I now have all my little thresholds here. Now let's ask some questions. Are you greater than 95? Well, that's a pretty simple formula. Equals this greater than or equal to 95, actually. And change those so that I don't forget later on. So is 100 greater than 95? Yeah, that's true. Equals, is this less than or equal to this? That's true. All right, so if I change it to 106, that turns false. That still is true. If I take it down to 94, Now that one's false and that one's true. So if both of those are true, then I want the word yay. So are both those true? Is it going to be a yay? So what's the formula to see if both of those are true? That's and. And that, comma, that. True. 106, it's false. 94, it's false. It's important to test out your formulas occasionally. So that all works. So now I say, if this is true, I want the word yay. Equals if this is true, comma. Now I'm going to put double quotes in here because I want to put in some text of yay. That's the only time you should ever put double quotes around something is if you've got a chunk of text here. Don't ever put it around words like true and false because those are Boolean values. And if you wrap them in double quotes, you won't get any right answers anymore. So it's either yay or, I don't know, let's just say not yay for now because I don't really know what I want. So if it's 94, it's not yay. If it's 100, it's yay. 106, not yay. All right, so far we're going. So we have this middle part done. But if it fails that test, if we go down here to the, if we go down here to this F21 and it's false, we come down here to this formula, I don't really want it to say not yay. I then want it to go to the next if, another if statement that then says, hey, are you greater than this value and less than this one? All right, so if we fail that test, we then want to go out to these next borders. Are you greater than 90%? This greater than or equal to this cell equals this cell is it less than or equal to 110. So we failed our first test, but we come out here to the second one. 106, we're right here, so we're between this line and this line, or in this case, 110 or 90. So now we need another formula that says if this and this are true, that means we're in the okay mode. So equals and this, comma, this. So down here, let's do another if statement. If it's okay, output okay. So, all right. Equals if this little logical test to see if it's true. If that's true, then I'm supposed to put out what? Double quote. Well, okay then. Double quote. Now I'm going to. Not really sure what to put here, so I'm going to say if we get down to this point, it's really not yay and not okay either. All right, so if it's 106, it's okay. Well, okay then. 111. Well, we're false on both of those. Not yay and not okay. Let's go the other direction. If it's, what's something in here? 92. So is it yay? No, it's false that it's yay. Is it okay? Yes, it's true that it's okay because we're both this and this are true. And if we fail both of those tests, let's take it down to 50. Both of those, this one is false, but this one's true. So both those are false. So it comes down here to this last part where it says not yay and not okay either. So we don't really want it to say not yay and not okay either. Our third choice is really boo. So do we need to come up with another set of tests that says, hey, are you less than this? Greater than this? Well, you could, but it's a lot easier to just say, oh, Rather than come up with yet another test, all we need to recognize is that there's only three possible outcomes here, right? You can either be here and it's yay, or here if it's okay. And if it's neither of those, what else possibly could it be? There's no other choice besides boo. So I don't need to come up with any more elaborate if statements or ands or ors or anything. I basically just need a choice of none of the above. If you think back to this, our first if statement, if that first one's true, then it's yay. If it's not true, we're actually going to bop down here to our second if statement, and we're going to check to see if it's true. And if it is, we're going to put that out. If that one fails, so it fails both of our tests, we don't really have to put this, well, not yay and not okay either. Here's where we can just put in our boo. So I'm going to wipe that out. Actually kind of works. So now actually all the pieces are here. So we've eaten our elephant, almost. We kind of have to combine some of this stuff. Right now our elephant is scattered out in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 bites. So we're going to combine these bites into one, and we are going to eat the elephant in one big bite. So how do we do that? We say in here, if F21, yay, not yay. Well, we don't want anything ever to say not yay, not yet. We want to replace this not yay with this other if statement that tells us whether or not it's okay or boo. So I'm going to highlight all that except for the equal sign. I'm going to hit Control C to copy. Escape key, that's the magic sequence here. And then I'm going to come in here and take out that not yay part here in the value if false and hit Control V to paste it in. And I'm going to highlight, now I'm going to make those disappear just so it's less confusing. So now let's see if it works all in that one. So if it's 50, it's boo. If it's 150, it's boo. If it's 92, okay then. If it's 108, well, okay then. If it's 96, yay. If it's 104, yay. So this formula is actually completely correct. The problem is it's still spread out into 11 bytes. So what we have to do is we have to consolidate all these bytes into one. And this is really easier than it looks. So we come down here to our final formula, and see it says if J21, then say yay. If F21, then do that. So this formula is reliant on the formulas in K21 and J21. So I'm going to come over here, hit the escape key, come over here to the formula in K21, highlight the formula, copy, escape, then come over here to where that K21 is in the formula, double click on it and hit paste. All right, now I'm not looking at that formula, so I'm gonna wipe it out. All right, we said that it's looking for J21, so let's get the formula out of J21, this little and statement. Copy, escape, come over here to our elephant. I'm just gonna read, I've got the formula J21 in memory. Hit paste, and now I can delete these cells, and it still works. So now if I come back in here, well, it's looking for cell F21. So let's find the formula in F21. That's this little beast here. Copy, escape, come back over here, double click on F21, paste. That formula, and it still works. All right, what's next? Looks like it's using cell B21. So come in here, find the formula in B21, copy, escape, B21, paste. Now I can delete those formulas. like it's looking for a formula in F2. That's this elephant bite up here. Copy. Escape. F2. Paste. Looks like it's looking for E21. Let's find the formula in E21. Actually, before we do that, let's just test it out and see if I've messed anything up. So 104 is yay. 106 should be, well, okay then. 111 should be boo. Boo. What about 50? Boo. 92. Well, okay then. All right, so my formula's still working. I haven't broken it yet. So what else can I replace? Looks like I've got a formula in E21 and C21. So let's find the formula in E21. Copy. Escape. E21. Paste. Oops, I got an equal sign in there. Let's find the formula. It's looking for C21. Get that formula without the equal sign this time. Copy, escape, find the C21. Now I can get rid of that elephant bite, and it still works. Now it looks like we're looking for E2 up here, yep. So let's highlight this. Copy, escape, find the E2. If it still works. Actually, let's delete it out of E2 just to really test it, see if it breaks. Let's do 96. Okay, still works. So we got to find the formula for C2. That's this one. Copy, escape, find the C2. All right, so delete C2. Probably ought to check it again. Notice I'm checking it over and over and over. When I don't really know what I'm doing or I'm not terribly confident in it and I'm putting everything back together, pretty easy to mess it up, so it's important to test it and do this slowly and methodically. So finally, we have a formula here in B2. Copy, escape. Find the B2 out of all this. There it is. And hit enter. And I think we're actually done. We have successfully eaten the elephant. So let's check it out just to make sure if we're at 80. Boo. 92. Well, okay then. 100 should be yay. 106 should be well, okay then. 111. Should be boo. And we don't have any of our little bites left over. This formula, the only thing it refers to is our starting point, these percentages, and the value that we want to see. Are you within plus or minus 5% of the center of 100? Are you within 10% of the center point? If so, put out well, okay then. If you're none of the above, put out boo. All right, well, that is the step of the assignment. I hope this really helps. What do you say, Fido? You a good dog? Can you guys see Fido? Hey. What do you say? Thanks for the kisses. All right, you guys have a great day. Thanks a lot.